Hi, I'm SanjayC. In this short series, I'll show you how to record music at home with the Universal Audio Volt Audio Interface. In this first video, we'll unbox it, register, and install some software, and get Volt connected. And hey, let's record a track or two as well. You don't need much to get started, just have your computer handy, and if you've got a microphone or an instrument available, we can test out the recording features as well. Make sure you watch all the videos in this series. I'll cover vocal recording, putting a song together using the included software, and I'll even give you some tips for using Volt for podcasting. For now, I'm sure you're excited to get Volt connected, so let's jump right in. Inside the box, you'll find the Volt audio interface and cables. Yes, new gear, I love it. You'll notice a website address printed on the box. Let's visit that website first to download the Universal Audio UA Connect app. The UA Connect app will help you register and download the included software. All right, downloaded. Run UA Connect and create an account. If you already have a UA Connect account, you can log in with your existing credentials. Once you're done, UA Connect will ask you to plug in your Volt, the moment we've been waiting for. Volt is bus powered, so you'll only need one cable to connect to your computer. But if your computer doesn't power Volt, you can use the USB power cable to connect it to a standard USB wall charger. For most computers, you're gonna be fine with just using the regular USB-C to USB cable. If your computer only has USB-C ports, you can use an adapter or use a USB-C to USB-C cable. Lights, we're ready to go. Okay, the UA Connect app automatically detects Volt. Click register and follow the directions to complete registration. If you're using Windows, make sure you also download the additional drivers when prompted. Volt comes with a bunch of software, including Ableton Live Lite, plugins from SoftTube, Melodyne, Relab, Plugin Alliance, UJAM, and more. We'll explore everything included in this video series. I suggest you install all the software included. It's all useful and hey, it's free. Make sure you install Ableton Live Lite because we'll be using that for the rest of this series. By the way, Volt audio interfaces are compatible with iPads and iPhones, so you can use them with iOS apps like GarageBand as well. But today we'll focus on computer recording. All right, we've got Volt connected to our computer and the software installed. Next, let's connect speakers, a microphone, and an instrument. On the back of Volt, you'll find two outputs labeled Monitor 1L and Monitor 2R. Here's where you connect your studio monitors. While we're back here, you'll notice MIDI in and out. This is for keyboards. These days, most keyboards come with USB connections, but if you have an old keyboard that only has MIDI connections, you can connect it here. All right, studio monitors connected. You can adjust the monitor volume using the monitor knob right here. On the front, you'll find inputs for a microphone or an instrument like a guitar. I'm using the Volt 276 right now, so I have two inputs. If you have a Volt 1, you'll have one input. The Volt 476 has two inputs in the front and two in the back. The front inputs are combo mic/instrument inputs, so you can connect a mic with an XLR cable or an instrument with a 1/4-inch TS or TRS cable. If you connect a guitar or bass, make sure you press the inst button for instrument. The last hookup is easy. Plug in your headphones into the headphone port in the front. We're done with all our connections. All right, let's get recording. Open Ableton Live Lite and let's make sure Ableton is listening to the Volt interface. Open Preferences and go to the Audio section. Select Volt as your audio input and output device. If you have a Volt 476, you can enable the additional inputs and outputs using the Input Config and Output Config buttons. If you're new to recording music at home, you may be wondering what Ableton Live Lite is. Live is a digital audio workstation, or DAW. DAWs are software that let you record sound into your computer, play built-in sounds, record multiple tracks, and mix everything into a song. You'll spend a lot of time with your DAW, and there's lots to learn, but I'll guide you through the basics in this video series. By the way, Volt is compatible with other DAWs, so if you prefer using something like Cubase, Logic, Pro Tools, go right ahead. All right, guess what? Setup is done. And as long as you keep your Volt interface connected, you won't have to do this setup stuff again. Now we can't leave without recording something. That's the most fun part. I've connected a mic to Volt. I'm using a condenser microphone which needs phantom power, so I'm going to press the 48V button on the front of the interface. If you're using a dynamic microphone like a Shure SM58, you won't need to turn on phantom power. If you're not sure what type of mic you have, check your mic's manual. Only use phantom power if your mic requires it. Now, I like condenser mics because they suit my voice better, but I'll demo a dynamic mic in another video in this series. In Ableton Live, select an audio track and choose one under Audio From. Here, we're telling Live what channel on Volt to listen to. If you want to record something you plugged into another input, select that instead. Volt has direct monitoring, which is useful for monitoring the input signal before it goes into your DAW. That way, you can hear yourself without any delay. Turn off input monitoring for that track in Live and turn on direct on Volt. Arm the track by pressing the round red button and then hit record. Oh, wait a sec, we better check our gain setting. I'm going to set the gain so that the input meter is just high enough that I don't get into the red when I'm singing or speaking normally. Let's record. All right, I'm testing out the Volt 276 audio interface with my condenser microphone. Now I stand where we were both here dancing once upon a time. Press stop or your space bar to stop recording. By the way, you've got this vintage button right here. Try recording with this activated.
Now I stand where we were both here dancing once upon a time.
The vintage preamp mode on Volt adds the warmth and presence of a tube preamp. We'll record more tracks with vintage in the next video. All right, you've recorded your first track and onto Spotify fame. Well, I wish it were that easy. But I've got you covered in the next couple of videos. We'll explore vocal recording, guitar recording, and I'll show you how I mixed and recorded this song using Volt.
Summer days gone by, red sunset, palm trees, dreaming of the nights in July. Never be the same, all those days with you, 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 you.